Get ready. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, Sir, before I continue further, I would like to offer you my wholehearted congratulations on your re-election to this high office. Sir, the specter of inflation has been raised. It is said that the monster of inflation is raising its hideous head and that there must be an effort all round to bring down prices. I would like to examine whether there is any justification for raising such a scare and whether there is any inflationary pressure at all on our economy. A false alarm has been raised by our critics to hamper our development expenditure and the development of our economy. While we must maintain a watchful approach, a cautious approach with a view to developing our economy and implementing our plans, an alarmist approach will only mean that we hamper the growth of our economy and our development expenditure. I admit that there has been of late a rise in prices. Now we have to examine whether this rise in prices is due to inflationary pressures. We all know that this is the peak season when there is the greatest demand for money in our economy. This demand for money is due to two factors at the present moment. It is due partly to the rise in our economic activity and partly due to seasonable factors. The figures of money supply which have stood at rupees 2150 crores at the end of March may taper off to rupees 2000 crores after the busy season is over. We have to see whether this supply of money is at all inflationary. What I feel is that in times to come, when the products reach the market, the supply of goods will match the money supply position. But we can also examine, apart from the money supply position, the rise in the price itself. The current statistics reveal that there has been a rise in the prices of food articles, industrial raw material, and semi-manufactured articles, but there has been a steady price for the manufactured articles. Now, I am sure the House will agree with me that we must maintain a certain parity in our economy between the agriculture products and the manufactured articles. We should see that our agriculturists don't suffer from our economic policies. We must examine whether the parity that is in existence today is a correct one. The point that I am making is that there has been a rise in the price of the agricultural products, and this rise has been brought about by a conscious planning effort. But there is no question of alarm for this rise of the price of the agricultural products, because as compared with pre-war levels of price index between the agricultural products and the manufactured articles, the price which the agriculturist gets for his produce is still 3% against him. Now, if we want to reduce the prices, we must reduce the prices of both the agricultural and the manufactured goods. There is no point in becoming alarmists only when the prices of the agricultural products are rising, because I am certain that there is still room for a rise of 3 points in this index. That is to say, there is still room for a slight rise in the agricultural prices before a pre-war parity could be achieved. Therefore, I maintain that there is no room for alarm or scare for the prices that have risen of the agricultural products. This has been as a result of a conscious effort, and there is no inflationary pressure in this rise of prices. Now, I also maintain that we should keep a watchful eye and we should not be complacent, because it is not my intention to advocate inflation. I merely want that a proper parity should be maintained, and in the name of inflation, we should not curtail our development expenditure in the plan. But for keeping this economy steady, we have to see that the supply of goods and services keep on increasing with the demand that is made on them with the rise in the economy, and we should not hesitate if there is a necessity to whittle down even our foreign resources and import large quantities of food in order to keep the prices down when our production of rice has not been better than last year and our rabi crop will not be as good as last year. We have provided for an import of 2 million tons of food grains in order to keep the prices at proper level. I was referring to the Reserve Bank bulletin for the month of March 1950. Therefore, I would beg of the finance minister and the government not to take a timid view of the situation, but to take a bolder step to implement the plan and in order to maintain the economy and the prices at the proper level, they should not hesitate to make large imports if found necessary.